early morning weather with meteorologist Mark Dixon.
And on this Monday evening across Connecticut, we are tracking another round of rain working into the western part of the state. So if your plans take you out and about over the next several hours, you will certainly need the umbrellas, the rain gear, the windshield wipers, as we do expect even later tonight, the chance for some thunderstorms. Right now, though, the rain fairly light as it's working through the Route 8 corridor toward I-91, and it will continue its eastward progression. Temperatures, though, have continued working in the upper direction. That is a trend that will continue as we head through the next several hours in the wake of a warm front with a southerly flow. We're up to 64 in Hartford, also Meriden, 65 Norwich, mid 60s along the shoreline as well. Still in the upper 50s in the northwest hills, but fairly steady, if not again rising, as we head through at least the next couple of hours before a cold front moves in and moves the wind direction from the south to more of a west-northwesterly direction. So our iCam view from Torrington showing the damp evening that is underway. The raindrops coming down there in the Litchfield Hills. Cloudy, of course, looking live from Middletown over the Connecticut River and the Aragoni Bridge into Portland. And our view from southeast Connecticut, the headlines on, you can see reflecting on the wet pavement there in the southeastern part of the state. So where we're not seeing the organized rain right now, certainly areas of drizzle as you head out and about this evening. More rain off to our west. You can see a thin band of some heavier activity working through Pennsylvania. That's in advance of a cold front that eventually works into Connecticut. So in advance of this front, we have a southerly flow of air that's bringing in also an unstable air mass. So the ingredients coming together in several hours for perhaps even a few rumbles of thunder, especially throughout, say, the southeastern half of the state as we head toward 10, 11 o'clock tonight. Then high pressure builds in from the west, and on the other side of this front, considerably cooler air. So Washington, D.C. right now at 70. We're in the 80s in Atlanta, but notice just to the west of that front, we go from the 50s into the 40s. So much of this week will feature after today below normal temperatures. So here's a look at Futurecast. 7 o'clock this evening, we've got that line of rain off to our west heading into Connecticut as we head toward 10, 11 o'clock tonight. So tracking perhaps even a few rumbles of thunder, and any storms that develop could produce the lightning, some gusty wind, and as well some heavier rain. Then that front quickly moves offshore as we start our day tomorrow for our Tuesday. We'll need the sunglasses for early tomorrow morning for the commute right on through the afternoon. Mostly sunny on tap for the day tomorrow. Temperatures to start off will be in the low to mid 40s inland, upper 40s along the shoreline. And again, clearing trend takes place after midnight and for tomorrow afternoon. 55 to 60 for many communities. Coolest in the northwest hills, warmest along the shoreline. The wind up out of the west northwest, perhaps some gusts to over 20 miles an hour. So on our early morning 7-day forecast, the normal high in the low 60s, cool weather basically sums us up all the way through the end of the week and toward the upcoming weekend. For Wednesday, temperatures low 40s to start, mid 50s by the afternoon. A slight chance for an isolated shower with another cold front. It will come through primarily dry. Behind that, about 10 degrees cooler on Thursday. The coldest morning will be Friday. So if your furnace has not kicked on yet, it very will likely do so before the end of the week. We'll start off with frost likely, especially across a good portion of inland Connecticut Friday morning, mid 50s that afternoon. Then the upcoming weekend, partly to mostly cloudy on Saturday, perhaps a shower. Hour, not a washout. Dry weather on Sunday. Temperatures trending cooler from Saturday into Sunday. So you can see that temperature roller coaster. Some big swings as we head toward the end of the week and into the upcoming weekend. For shoreline highs this weekend, near 60 on Saturday, then considerably cooler by Sunday afternoon.